Presley at ActOutGames.com here, and today I am writing for my writing class tomorrow because, whoops, I completely forgot I had one. But that's fine because now I have, let's see. My writing is currently called The Shame Dumpster. That is the nickname for I am 400. My character that I'm writing about is a really terrible person, so I decided that I would put her in the shame dumpster, which means I'm just going to remove her from the game she's in for a little bit, and then do this.
And how many words have you written so far?
400. And it's just a ton of emotional pain, and then she'll develop and stop being a terrible person. So that's what the shame dumpster is. And I have, she's still not a good person, but she drank some water. That's probably the most eventful thing that happened in my writing.
So if you remember in our other video, we did the cat grass, and now it's fully grown.
Well, it's, I don't know if it's fully grown, but it definitely has sprigs. Do you think Domino would eat it?
Maybe.
Sure. Let's take it inside and see if he'll eat.
Take a bite, Domino.
What do you think? Look, Domino, it's cat grass. Look. Look,
it's
Domino.
It's for you.
Domino.
It's for you. It's good for you. Bite it. Take a bite.
Okay. Domino doesn't seem to be super excited about the cat grass, but we'll put it over here by his food and see what happens.
Yeah. That was what I was going to do. So next lights.
Yeah, we'll just put it there. And we'll keep you posted on if he likes it.
Okay, so I have 4 pages of writing now, which is, or almost 4 pages, 3 and 3/4 or something, which is 1,312 words, which is, I think, gives me 3 levels that I can't even claim right now because you can only level up 10 times. But still good. I am going to read about the first page of it, maybe a little less, maybe a little more, until I get to a good stopping point. There's a flash of white light, then black, then pain. I'm awake, I know that at least, but I can't see anything or move my arms. I could be blindfolded, or perhaps there's a spell on me. Whatever it is, I want to see. I attempt to move my arms, but they're bound tight. I can hear footsteps, likely from a rabbit, and the rushing of a river. I can smell fear in the forest. The fear might be my own, or someone else's. I can feel the ground at my feet, and something around my arms, probably ropes. I try to fall forward and succeed, but I hear a painful crack, and I feel pain in my nose. Great, I bet I just broke it. I can tell that I'm not tied to anything but my own self. Maybe I can cut my ropes on a sharp rock. My legs aren't bound to anything, so I stand up. My tail isn't bound either. Oh yeah, by the way, she's a kitsune. She has one singular foxtail, unless she's in it. She's kind of complicated, but currently she has one singular foxtail and fox ears. And the foxtail is about half the size of her body. So just gotta point that out. And her name is Ariadne Lockwood. Yes, she usually goes by Ari, so it's weird to me to say her full name. My tail isn't bound either, so I use it to pull out the ropes on my arms. They fall slack around my waist. At least one thing went right today. I was in the wagon with my friends, and I remember going to bed. That was the last thing I could do. That was the last thing I remembered. I sigh and yank at the blindfold. I can see now. I'm in the middle of a forest. There's no obvious civilization around, but there is a river I can get clean water from. That's useful. I pull the ropes off my waist and walk towards the river. The water is clear, and I probably won't die from it. I may get sick, but at least it's survivable. I reach for my bag. It's there. I sigh. That makes my life much easier. I pull a cup from it and stick it in the river. The water feels cold against my hands. Once it's full, I take a drink. It's not the best drink I've ever had, but it will work. I've been tossed out before. I know that everything revolves around survival. But I don't think my friends would toss me out. Oh well, I've been wrong about people before. It's not the end of the world. I do miss them, but if they'd abandoned me in the middle of a forest, I doubt that they actually care. I finish my drink and put the cup back in my bag. That's the first page. Should I keep going?
No, that's good.
Yay! Spoiler alert, her friends didn't actually dump her out, she's just being dramatic. She thinks that her friends abandoned her. They didn't. She was kidnapped. That's a big spoiler, but still, that's what happened.
Is there a title to this?
The title is The Shame Dumpster.
Oh yeah, you said that. You think that would be the title?
I mean, it's not being published, and it's a story about me theoretically throwing her in a shame dumpster. I actually drew her earlier. I think this is in this giant stack of drawings. The shame box. There she is in the shame box. That's her shame box.
Okay, so very good. Everybody comment, but I mean, I think Presley's writing is pretty good.
Look at Oliver, too. This is Oliver. He's a character from the same universe as her. He's not her brother, but she acts like it anyway. I couldn't draw that leg. I was having issues. Oliver Oil, Rowan, and he's amazing, and I'm really proud of him. He's my character, and I really love that character. He's very fun to play. So, yeah, I might keep writing this, I might not. Who knows?
Okay, so Cooper wants to show me some of the spring stuff that's happening, yeah?
So, yeah, that was the cat grass, and now we have a jelly here. We have some grapes.
Those are called purple hyacinth. Mm-hmm. Or grape, I'm sorry, you're right. Grape hyacinth. Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Some grapes.
And then these are my favorite peonies, but they need a little more time.
I see some red ones.
And we have tulips. I took some inside. But Abba said that cats can't be around tulips, so she put it up high. That's what we're talking about. I want you to bend down and smell that. That is hyacinth, and that smells real good. We'll bring it inside. Now this guy's ready to come inside. This is hyacinth as well. Now smell that sucker. This one's ready to come inside. The other one may need a day or two. Yep, we got more tulips.
Mm-hmm, we got
lots of grape hyacinth. And then over here, I saw some more.
There's a yellow plant.
Yeah, our forsythia.
It's starting to bloom.
Yeah, it's doing awesome. And then I saw over here, we'll bring this guy inside.
Pick it.
Okay, so like
you
I said,
one,
you
I
go, but
one.
You go all the way to the bottom, okay? All the way to the bottom of the stem there, and then you can kind of pop it off.
Ah!
Oh, good! Nice job, Cooper. The highest of all and nine.
Bang.
Yeah, it's gonna make it smell real good around here.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Cooper.
So I'm currently in sewing class, and I am making a Kigurumi. So the first thing we're sewing is this tail. These little white parts on to the orange parts of the tail. And I've used a sewing machine maybe twice. So we're going to have to figure out how I'm supposed to use this. We're currently, you did that, thank you.
You just pull it out.
Yeah. We're figuring out, we're currently changing the thread color, and we have to re-spin the bobbin, and I don't know how to do that.
Cool, that's a good thing to learn.
I've seen it before, mm-hmm. It looks very cool.
Most sewing machines have a diagram that tells you where it goes from there.
So you put that handle down.
The handle down.
Yeah, and then get your thread not through the handle. Yeah.
Not through the handle?
Yeah, like that. Yeah, just leave the handle down. Yeah, you're perfect. So did you see the diagram?
I see the diagram. I have to stick it in here.
And you want to end up back here.
I want to end up back there? Just.
So, yeah, this is for threading it for sewing.
Five.
To do your bobbin, you're going to come back here. So you can take this off, actually.
Oh.
I think it actually goes the other way, doesn't it? I think this one like rotates. Yeah, that way.
That way?
Yep. That one does a weird thing. And then you need the bobbin.
And you want the hole up because that's a mnemonic for front.
That's good then. So wait. So thread through the hole. So go inside and out the hole.
Before I put it on the thing.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I need to pull the end of this.
No, that's right. Just through here. Just go through, like it's going to wrap around the spool.
Okay.
But then just go through the hole. Doesn't really matter which one, if there's one on both sides.
Oh, I think there's one on both sides. Sorry.
Not from, yeah, there you go.
I did it.
Okay. So you can go ahead and pull it. You got a little more than you need, but that's okay. And now this goes on here with a thread coming out the top.
So it's coming out the top.
The hole. Got it?
Yes.
All right, so now pull this. More taut, so pull the thread up until it's a little bit. Yeah, not super tight, but yeah, that's fine. Right there.
So instead, move this towards this.
Okay.
Sometimes they work different ways. Okay, so now see how this little gear is on that?
Yes.
So now really gently step on the foot pedal.
Okay, so I have to still hold this?
Yeah, just for a second. You see it'll start wrapping right here? Okay, that's good, that's good. Stop. So now we can cut this off. Scissors?
Oh, okay, yes, I'm doing that.
So cut that really close to the bobbin.
Super close?
Yeah, yeah, super close. Yeah. Okay, now you can step on it a little bit more. Don't, it's not, you know, the throttle on your Ferrari. So you just want to let it wind up. Just let it go for a little while. So technically the way this is set up, when the thread gets bigger, it'll push on this plastic piece and turn itself off.
Oh, okay.
But you don't need to get it that full.
Yeah.
It's fine. I think Presley is threading her first bobbin.
Yes, in fact, that's in fact the true fact. In fact, the true fact in English.
Yeah, that's probably plenty for you to start with. So now, disconnect it, push it forward. Remember, slide it off. Yep, there you go. Now take it off the top.
And
scissors.
The thread.
And then you get to see how to put the bobbin in the machine.
Yay.
I'll come around this side, because there's some...
Should I do this part first?
No, do the bobbin. Go ahead and put the bobbin where it goes first, since you have been working on it. Nope.
No?
This one's a little bit different. Oh. So see, there's that little switch right there.
Yes.
Push that, and the little thing will pop up, and then take that plastic cover off.
And take this plastic thing out, I assume.
Yep, so there's a bobbin in there already, so you're going to get rid of that. And there's a... Wait, is there a... Oh, there's not a bobbin holder for this one.
Just kind of stick it in there.
Yeah, you kind of stick it in there, and then
there's a little, another little line.
Catch.
It's another little line in there that shows you kind of how the thread goes.
It's right here.
Oh.
Oh, it's on the cut. There we go.
You need to show it on. You need to do it over here.
So look at the drawing.
Okay.
And it'll tell you which way the thread should come off your bobbin. Number one.
So it should come off down here.
To make sure it's not up. It's the right side up.
Mm-hmm.
And then it'll show you the two little, like these little hooks here that it catches on.
Mm-hmm. And we have a hook here.
Yep.
To be
I don't think it goes around that.
Oh, it just goes in here?
I think it just goes. There's like that little hole right there, kind of. I mean, it just kind of slides in there.
Slide through?
Well, you just kind of push it in a little bit.
It's in.
Okay, all right. Well, so leave it there.
Okay.
Now do this part up here. And then we'll test
can
it
I
and
put
see.
This on?
You can if you want to.
I want to make it look neat.
Yeah.
I
you just have to be careful with that.
First.
Yeah, so that goes under.
Okay.
Be real gentle.
This is kind of terrible.
Okay, yeah, that's good. All right, we'll have to make and see, because see, you're pinching this piece.
Mm-hmm.
We need to make sure that it's not holding it so tight you can't get it out, but we'll see what happens here in a second when you load it.
Oh, that's
all right, so now follow the diagram again.
So 1, 2, 5.
Yeah, nope, so down, no, 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 down 3. Find
oh,
3.
Down
don't,
there.
Don't skip the 5.
3, 4. I just thought this entire step was 5. I'm like, why?
Yeah, and then here we want this up here, yep, oh, so see, you can find it there. So see which way it goes around.
This way.
Wait, come back. Come off of it.
It goes around that
come back
way.
Towards you.
Oh, come back towards me?
Yeah, I just want to make sure you're going on this side and then around. Yep.
Yes.
And then down.
Down.
And through the needle. Through. Well, actually, there's a little, is there a retainer
there's
on that one?
Little tiny right there.
You want to go through that. There's a thread through. No, it's a hole, so you got to stick the end through.
Oh, boy.
No, it's something that you pull through.
You you pull through that one?
And then you sew it?
And you probably will want to put a fresh cut on the end of that before you thread the needle.
Yeah.
It makes it easier.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I went through it. I was going through it that way, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, so put a nice clean cut. Make it easier to thread.
Oh.
And now you want to go through the needle. So see here, this turn, see the needle goes up and down?
Mm-hmm.
So you want the needle kind of up at the top. And then if you look, there's that little white plate there.
Yes.
It kind of helps you see the hole.
Oh,
I'm not sure if that's the only purpose that it serves, but it does that.
It does that.
You can wet your thread a little bit too if you want to, but since it's a clean cut, you probably don't need to.
Mm-hmm.
We all know how much you like putting things in your mouth.
I like putting things in my mouth. I love that crunch.
So now you want to hold the piece that you took out. Come on, no. I'm saying I'm coming to this side. It'd be weird if you had to come over here to finish putting the thread in your machine. So you want to hold this,
okay,
and then with your other hand, you want to turn the top toward you. And so it's going to go down, and then when it comes back up, if you lift on this a little bit, You'll feel when it, wait, whoa. So you feel how it released there?
Yeah.
And so look, you see the thread underneath?
Mm-hmm.
See how it's moving when I pull? So see, it pulled that piece of thread up?
Ooh, that's good.
So now, okay. use your hand and grab that other piece of thread that came up from the bottom.
This part?
Yeah, watch, there's a needle there, so be very careful.
Okay.
One side will come up real easy and one side won't. Okay, you need the other side. Because this is where you've pinched this in. So you may open that door.
Sometimes this kind of locks it
down. Yeah, that's what I mean. You may open that door and move that so you can now pull it up. Mm-hmm. So you want to pull this loose end out.
Do I have to hold this one still?
Here, I'll hold this one for you.
Sometimes it's
to just find the right one. There you go. That's the right one. All right. So now we've got both of them out up here. Oh, so yeah, put your little trap door back on.
Okay.
Be very careful. Remember, put the tip in first.
Tip in first.
And that can break very easily. Okay, so now both sides, go ahead.
Yeah, now we need both sides to come through the foot.
And out the back.
And out the back.
Through the foot and out the back, okay.
So this is how you will sew. So now let's find you a nice scrap piece to test and see how things are working.
Okay. Nice.
Pooch on.
You could actually see.
Yes.
So you just threaded the machine.
Yay!
We hope.
I hope.
Okay.
Yeah, you do it on white. You can see it. Okay, so what, you know what you do first?
I put it here and then I...
Nope.
What do I do first?
There's another thing you gotta do.
I don't remember this.
You gotta put the foot down.
Foot. Oh.
Back here.
Yeah, I remember that.
So back, reach way back here where my hand is. Push that down.
All the way back.
Yep, huh. So see the foot went down?
Yes.
So now, very gently, again, on the pedal.
Ah,
okay.
It's okay.
Okay, now stop.
No.
Foot up.
Lift the foot up.
So all the way back around by me, down there. Yep, that's it. No, that's it. Lift up. So now pull the thread back. Scissors, cut the thread. So you need to cut both pieces of thread. So pull it back a little bit. So you want to leave these a little bit long because sometimes they'll get kind of wrapped back up in the machine. Yeah, you could definitely do that from the other side if you didn't want to stick the scissors through the hole there.
Thank you.
Okay, pooch on. Hey.
Pay attention.
We did sharpen the scissors.
Yes, oh, okay. That was helpful.
All right, so this
is a zigzag.
Let's see if I can get it to focus. There it goes. Oh, it's trying. Oh, there we go. A nice little zigzag stitch.
Yes, there's a lot of excess.
What do you think, Bijan? Yeah, you end up with a lot of thread hanging out.
It's cool. It's terrifying.
Do you know why it's a zigzag? Why we're using a zigzag for what we're doing?
I don't know why we're using a zigzag for what we're doing.
But you can see how it's set to a zigzag.
Yes.
Well, think about how something stretch. And if it's a zigzag,
it makes it easier to stretch.
The stretch,
stretchy.
The thread stretches instead of going bing.
Right, instead of breaking.
Yes.
Right? So since we're using a fabric that stretches a little bit, you want to use a zigzag.
What causes
it to look like that? If you're ever sewing
correct.
And it looks like that.
Absolutely.
It's because, come on, focus.
Art.
There we go. If this is what you get, then it's probably because you didn't put your foot down.
Yes, it's beautiful.
Everybody needs, I wonder if that's part of putting your foot down.
Yeah.
The expression to put your foot down.
I have no idea.
I never thought of it until right this second, but I did just say put your foot down a couple of times.
Yeah.
I don't know if that would be related or not.
I don't know. Sewing machine's about 160 years old at this time.
So possible.
How old is the expression to put your foot down?
I don't know.
I think I've Googled this before. I think it's from roughly, I have to figure out if my medieval characters could actually say something.
I guarantee you one of our subscribers will know and they'll let us know.
Tell us. I think
we've got a pretty smart group out there. They'll let us know. Step one.
Put this thing.
Foot down. Yep.
Okay.
Now step on the pedal.
I'm looking horrible.
Hold on.
Okay. What's the problem here?
It's bunching.
Okay. What do we do to keep things together?
Ooh, we should pin them. That is a good idea.
Climber here too. Oh, it's just starting to curl up.
That, and sometimes what you can do is you can pick it up.
Yeah, you probably want both under the foot before you put it down.
Under the foot.
Okay. There might be some instances where you don't.
Okay, try that.
Yeah, try that.
There we go.
What are we doing?
We are sewing that thing on.
You're showing the stripes on?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
As it says, you know, pin.
So you want to look, so you can see pretty clearly there where your needle's going to hit. That's why there's kind of a hole there, right?
It hits and so not exactly on the edge.
You want to be sure that it's pretty close to the edge
mm-hmm.
and that it's pretty close to lined up with where you want it to be, right? As far as the width.
Yes, that looks fine.
So that, you know, you probably want to be pretty close to, like you could probably
when you're trying to line up your fabric, mm-hmm. you want to line something up. And so you've got the side of that stripe. Mm-hmm. And so you could probably with that even use, run the side of the stripe down the side of the foot. I mean, there's probably a little more clearance than you need. Curved. What do you mean?
It's not like a straight line.
Yeah, that's okay. You can move that a little bit. So just to kind of get started and have like a really nice edge guide of where you want to do. No. So other this edge.
Oh, this edge?
Yeah. No. This edge of the thing on this side of the foot.
Oh.
Right? Because you want the needle to land on the fabric. So if you put this over there. Yeah, so you can push it out more if you want to. I mean, you can go closer to the edge and just kind of watch the needle. Yeah. But it's easier to keep straight if you have a
right
guide.
Right there okay. is probably where the zigzag is going.
Okay, you ready? Okay, just take your time and go slow. Is it all the way through?
It should be.
Yep.
Did
that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I did the thing.
Next time when you get to the end, stop for a second. Let me show you how to do a back stitch on it to lock it in.
Oh, yeah, I've done that.
It's okay. Not a big deal.
If you're going to go over it with another seam,
on the outside,
back stitch
yeah.
is not right. always necessary. Right.
There we go. Look at that. Nice job, Bhujan.
Yay.
Dozo.
It still doesn't mean that I can make an entire cosplay, but...
All right, this could totally be a cosplay.
Everybody's
this is a Sunday... Yeah. Well, when you're finished with this you could make a full cosplay. It is a Sunday cosplay.
Okay, right. So we just got, my service just arrived because my laptop that is a MacBook Pro was being super glitchy and taking a really long time to start up in, Texas, so we decided that we would get a replacement one, and so we did. We got a Surface, what Surface is this?
Pro 3.
A Surface Pro 3, which is one generation up from the Surface that I used to have and broke. But I'm still super duper excited about it, and I'll probably be doing a lot of drawing from the Surface now. But yeah, I still need to mess around with it and, kind of figure out what I'm doing. We just got, like, literally 2 seconds ago, just got Photoshop on the Surface.
Mm-hmm.
So this is probably what I'm going to be drawing on, for a little bit, and for some animations that are coming up, I'm going to try drawing on the Surface. And then importing that to my main computer and animating them from there.
And
new bite-sized science videos we're working on. She's doing the animations for. I think she'll do the drawings here, and then use After Effects on her main computer to do the animations.
Yeah, After Effects on here might be like a bit of a disaster.
Yeah, I don't think you're gonna run After Effects on this thing, but mm-hmm. I think you can do your drawings on it. It'll be Photoshop just fine.
Yes.
Cool.
And we're gonna get a nice big giant case.
Military grade. Case. Like, there's a bunch of drop tested
case.
Yeah. Hopefully I'm not taking this into like a battlefield, but
it seems like you do.
Yeah.
We need it to survive a battlefield.
Okay, so we'll let me finish getting set up and then tomorrow you can show some drawings on it.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, get us out of here.
So yeah, thank you for watching and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!